Ich frag nicht, woher ich komme. Ich frag nicht, wohin ich geh. Hier und jetzt ist meine Zeit, auch wenn ich manches nicht versteh. Ich stell keine großen Fragen, nehm das Leben, wie es ist. Will ein Tag auf Erden werden, den man nicht so schnell vergisst. Ich bin nur heute.
Hello YouTube, this is Brianna, and this is week 9 of Hot for Halloween. Only 3 weeks to Halloween, 21 days, who is excited? This is my rag doll, patchwork doll kind of look. It was really fun to paint and do. So this week, how did I do? What's going on? Weight-wise, I will say that I am still around 191. I mentioned that I was going to start weighing myself every 2 weeks, doing official weigh-in. So next week will be what I really officially weigh in, whatever that is, which I know will be less. It doesn't matter that I maintain. It doesn't matter at all to me because I feel fabulous times 1,000. My food this week was pretty good, not as good as it could have been, but what was really great was my exercise. My exercise was great. I finally really stuck my mind to it and got back in the swing of things and got back into it. I did all my running this week. Best of all, I got back into my actual gym classes yesterday, and let me tell you, was my body missing that? I mean, really. It was so hard, but so worth it and so awesome. After 2 hours of body fitness and body combat, I was sweating and I was shaking. I was shaking like crazy because the instructor put in all this new weird balancing stuff where we had to use all these core muscles that apparently I've never used in my life. And like my legs were just like shaking and my arms were shaking and my legs. It felt so great. I felt like I finally pushed myself so far that I couldn't even stand up anymore, which, I don't know, it just makes it all worth it. It feels like you really put in the time that you need to put into. And now today, I can barely breathe. Every single muscle in my body is sore. I don't care what I weigh today because nothing can take away the fact that I worked my butt off yesterday and I am back on track and I feel amazing. I feel great. I feel so energized. And did I say I feel amazing, feel great? I think I probably said about 100 times already in this video. That's how I feel. So I hope everybody out there is feeling exactly the same as me. Totally pumped and stomping your feet and really pushing through the next 3 weeks. Wow, I don't even drink coffee and I feel like I'm completely caffeinated right now. Yeah, so, Christy's main goal thing from her video this week is acceptance. This is really hard for me, but I'm gonna try to explain how I feel about this topic. I by no means accept myself completely, but I am happy to say that I accept myself a million times more than I did before I started this journey. And let me tell you, when I started this journey, I did the same thing that everybody does. I looked at these pictures of these perfect, picture-perfect models, these size zero models with everything perfectly situated and everything perfectly photoshopped. And I would look at these pictures and I would always set that as my goal. And I would say, I'll use this, I'll work towards this. But in my head, it was not about working towards it. It was about, I wanted to get from where I was to there in one step. And that was the only choice that I had in my head. That's what I felt like. That is the only choice I had. And what happened was, this stopped me from starting because it was such a huge thing to think about that there was no point in me starting it because it was like if I tried to get to the stars. And the thing is that that was always holding me back. You think you set your goals high and you'll get there, but it, I mean, something like that is, it was silly of me. It was silly. And it was because I felt like I, the person that I was at that point, was not good enough. And the only way I would be good enough is if I look like a complete stranger. I mean, a totally different person, not me at all. Some weird Photoshop from a magazine. And this was unrealistic, but this is, I mean, I completely didn't accept anything about myself because that's what I wanted. And that's what I was mentally brainwashing myself into believing. And finally, whatever this the switch was that flipped in my head that got me going and losing weight, it had nothing to do with that picture anymore. I mean, it was only about me. I realized the only time that I'm truly successful with this weight loss is when I am thinking only about me and what I want this person and this body to become. And it seems like as I am working on this, this is me, and this is that picture of the type 0 person, as I'm working towards my goal, I'm getting closer and closer and closer to these goals, and this whatever magazine person is slowly disappearing, and it's becoming me, and it's becoming me, and somewhere in the middle, I feel that it's going to meet, and I'm going to find a place where I am happy with myself as myself, and there is no longer anybody else that I am wanting to be. And you know, every day I feel that a little bit more. Every day I look in the mirror and I see the changes, and I see the strength that is building inside of me, and that I'm happy with that person. And I have to accept this person, because when I reach my goal, my body is not going to disappear and become somebody else. Like, I'm still me, no matter what happens. I am me, and if the majority of my problems come from my brain, I can't escape that, and I know that. And, you know, and I'm willing to accept that. I'm willing to love the person inside of me for who she is, because, you know, she's all right, and that is the most important thing. And I'm learning that, and it just so happens that I am losing weight in the process, which is great, and I'm feeling great, and I'm taking care of myself, and that positivity makes me want to take better care of myself. And I think when I become a healthy person, it's inevitable. All those things will come together. And I might never fully accept everything about myself. Like Christy said, it's always hard, but I know that I can work for it, and if I want something, I work for it, and I remember that it's always going to be me there in that point. And it's me that can make it, or that can't make it, or doesn't choose to make it. I have a little bit of acceptance that I have right now. Next week I am going on vacation, which will involve me being probably on a beach in a bathing suit, which is the farthest thing away from my mind and my choices, but I will tell you that a year ago, I never would have done that. I never, ever, ever, ever would have done that. And I'm okay, and I trust the people that I'm with, and I'm good enough this way. And I'm not worried about it. I'm gonna enjoy myself, and I know where I'm going with my goals. I know where I'm going, I know where I'm going, and I know I'm gonna get there. And no one can take that away from me. Nobody can take away what I do for myself, what I choose to feel about myself, and what I make of myself. And that is important. So that's it for this week. That's my rambling. I hope that everybody is having a wonderful, 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 wonderful week. And I will talk to you guys next week. Bye.